This is posterolateral aspect of the wrist. Here there is a triangular depression called anatomical snuff box. This anatomical snuff box will be well seen when thumb is extended. Here the base or upper limit of the anatomical snuff box. Here the apex. This is anterior or lateral or anterolateral boundary. This one is posterior or posteromedial or medial boundary. Here the roof. Roof is formed by skin, superficial fascia and deep fascia. The floor is placed very deep. The anterior boundary or anterolateral boundary or lateral boundary is formed by two tendons. They are abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis. Posteromedial or medial or posterior boundary is formed by only one tendon, that is extensor pollicis longus. Anatomical snuff box. It is a triangular depression present on posterolateral aspect of the wrist. It is well seen when thumb is extended. It has the base, anterior boundary, posterior boundary, the roof, the apex, the floor. The base is formed by lower end of styloid process. Anterior boundary is formed by abductor pollicis longus, then extensor pollicis brevis. Posterior boundary is formed by extensor pollicis longus. Apex is formed by meeting point of these two boundaries, anterior and posterior boundaries. Roof is formed by skin, superficial fascia and deep fascia. The floor is formed by three bones. They are scaphoid, trapezium, then metacarpal, first metacarpal bone. The contents are radial artery, that is the deepest content, then superficial branch of radial nerve and cephalic vein present in the superficial fascia.